Hi there, today we're going to have a look at making IR impulses from your speaker cabinets. Hi, I'm Ulf at HoboRec. I'm back from Vietnam, and so far so good, no coronaviruses yet, so let's hope for the best. Yeah, as I said, the plan for this week's video is just to show you how you can make your own impulse responses. Want to be at home recording with Sims, but you still want to have your own character. There is a lot of cab IRs out there, and you get them with your like amp plugins and stuff like that. But if you want to make your own, like put your little own touch on it, it can be a good idea to make a couple of your own to get that little detail that is your own and no one else can have the exact same. So I'm going to show you that today, but also I like just stumbled upon another topic because I'm going to use a new microphone we have here today that we got from a microphone builder that made it a couple of custom built microphones for us. It's like a FET version of a U67. It's like the, how the builder thought the U67 sounds, and he made a FET version, which is much cheaper than a tube microphone. The cool thing is that he made it with the front and back plate of the diaphragm with separate outputs. Which means you can blend it however you want, or you can also put it in reverse the polarity of one side and fade them together to like create your own polar pattern. And that's something that I talked with the guys from Lewitt Microphones about. They have a microphone that can do that. They have two outputs from the front and back of the diaphragm, and then they have a plugin that lets you choose the polar pattern after you record it. And that's pretty much what you can do with this microphone too. So I downloaded the Lewitt software to make it more pleasing for you to see. And it seems to work pretty fine with this microphone too. So shout out to Lewitt Microphones for having that software for free. So you can use it with any mic that has separate outputs for the front and back plate, which pretty much no microphones has.
Yeah, so this is the setup we have. It's the Malmberg cabinet with this custom built U67 FET microphone. And it's running into here, you see on two different inputs, so it's front and back.
So I'm going to use this program called Voxengo Deconvolver. It's a Windows application. I use a program called Wine Butler to use it on Mac. It's supposed to be some software for Logic where you can make IRs too. I haven't dived into that because I don't have Logic, so this is the way I'm going to do it. First you have to generate a test tone. For this project now we go with 24-bit, 44.1 kilohertz, mono channel, 12 seconds. Generate, and then we save it. And now I brought this file into Cubase, and we're going to play it through the cabinet and record it here on this stereo track so that Lewitt Polarizer can take care of the polar pattern. If you want a real clean and accurate representation of your cab, you should play this test tone through a good reamp box into a really clean solid state amplifier and then to the cab. But in this case, we're going to play it through a Marshall Silver Jubilee, but I'm just going to use the power amp section so we don't get the coloration from the preamp. And here we have the track now recorded through the cabinet. I'm going to listen to it with the microphone set in cardioid mode. Next step is to export this as a mono sweep file that we can import into Voxengo Deconvolver. And it's important to have this little extra time at the end of it compared to the original sweep file. I don't know why, but if you don't have it, it won't work. So I will export one sweep file for each polar pattern in the Lewitt Polarizer plugin so that we get 8 different characters on our IR. Okay, so we go into Voxengo Deconvolver, and we're going to start here with loading the test tone file that Voxengo needs to compare the original test tone to the result we had through the cabinet. So there we have that. And since we only have the demo version, we can only process one file at a time. So we're going to open sweep one. And I want to put it into the folder called done And then we just process. And in that folder, we get something called sweep1dc. So that means deconvolve. I'm gonna rename all the files and share it with you afterwards. You can find a link to where you can find all those IRs in the description of the video, so you can have it for free. I'm just gonna keep doing this until I have all the 8 different files. Before we load those files into the cab IR loader, I wanna show you what the guitar sounds like when I record it with a distortion pedal through the amp, through the cabinet before, so we have something to compare with. The setup I have is the HM2 pedal through the Marshall Silver Jubilee and out through the Malmberg speed cabinet. Sounds like this. Yeah. Now, just for a little sidetrack of this video, as I said, the front and back plate is separate on its microphone, so I run it through the Lewitt polarizer plugin. It looks like this. Right now, I have it set to cardioid and sounds like this. And if we would have it in neutral, I think that's just the same volume on both sides. It's a round taking. And back to cardioid. We can also hear it like, I can switch between all of them and you can see how much it affects the sound. It's like a total different tool than using an EQ. I think I like the cardioid the most. It's like the most standard way to record, so it feels the most familiar in this case. Okay, so now let's listen to what we can do with the impulse responses. So we're going to use this free plugin from Lancaster Audio called Pulse. They have one built-in IR response, but you can also load your own. Omni, subcardioid, cardioid, supercardioid, bidirectional, and then some of them reversed. So we're just going to go the first one, and then we will have the full list here. So we're going to compare the cardioid one, since that's the one I like the most. I'm going to record the HM2 pedal straight into the computer, and then we're going to apply the impulse response and see if we get anywhere close to when we played it through the original signal chain. Let's see. Yeah, it's actually pretty cool. So, again, thank you so much for watching, and leave questions and comments. I'll try to answer and participate in the discussions, and see you again in the next one. Bye-bye. Cheers.